Hardy Boys are in the ring. They're ready for tag team action as we await the arrival of the Truth Commission here in Kansas City, where...
Well, now the lights have just gone out.
Like, you know, come on. Somebody playing a joke back there.
That is not on the format.
My God, it's Kane. It's Kane and Paul Bearer. We saw Kane last night literally rip a steel door right off its hinges. We're supposed to have a tag team matchup here with the Truth Commission, and now we have a monster. The younger brother of the Undertaker King, or so Paul Bearer tells us.
Well, you know, nobody wants...
Oh, God! Jeez. Hellfire and brimstone.
Nobody wanted to believe that what Paul Bearer had said was true, but it looks like seeing is believing.
And there...
Oh!
Double chokeslam with ease. A double chokeslam with ease. And this is a seven-foot monster that looks to be... I mean, it's a stone or granite.
Oh!
Now Matt Hardy tossed outside like a small child, like a little baby. What must the Undertaker think of this whole situation?
Look at this! Look at this! Oh, my gosh!
Jeff Hardy. And this is just... Look at this man. Look at the face. Look at the eyes.
Now that I have your undivided attention. Yes. Laugh at the fat man. Go ahead. Here's your chance. Go ahead and laugh at me. Stand up. Call me names. Do what you want to do. Here's your chance. The one you should be laughing at is your so-called phenom. The one you should be laughing at is your hero, The Undertaker. The proof is here. I tried to go back to The Undertaker. He wouldn't take me back. I had to do what I had to do. He slapped me around. He called me a liar. He burned me. But, ladies and gentlemen, let me present to you The Undertaker's little brother, Kane. Look close, Undertaker. The whole world saw your face last night when you stood for the first time in 20 years face to face with your own brother. We can all tell by the look in your eyes that you knew it was him. Yes, oh yes, he's alive. Look at his eye, Undertaker. He's missing an eye. And it's your fault. The 20 years of suffering, the 20 years of hiding out is now over, and we have you to thank, Undertaker. Undertaker, this is your stop sign on your highway to eternity. Starting with these boys tonight, we are going to walk through the World Wrestling Federation. Take each one, each wrestler, one by one, and destroy them until we reach you. You, Undertaker. That is why Kane is here. And we have you to thank. Every time you look around, you're going to see your brother behind you. Every time you close your eyes to go to sleep, you're going to remember that terrible night, the fire. Oh, yes, the fire. Undertaker, welcome to your worst nightmare.
Right here tonight. I'd like to see it.
Well, no doubt that could happen, especially considering the frame of mind that the Michaels is in. I think it could infuriate it.
Now Shawn Michaels' music for the lights. If you want. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes Kane. He is a seven-foot brother of The Undertaker. And Paul Bearer has been speaking long and loud about a challenge made to The Undertaker. Paul Bearer wants The Undertaker to fight his brother Kane. And until the day that The Undertaker accepts that challenge, Paul Bearer has said that Kane will make The Undertaker's life a living hell.
Did you see the look on The Undertaker's face at Hell in the Cell when this monster walked down and looked? The same look you've got there on Fox face,
right? Well, what is he doing in here now?
Flash Fucker. But Flash has got to defend himself. Flash Fucker scheduled to meet Shawn Michaels, but Flash is in for a fight right here.
And Flash Fucker.
Oh, wait a minute.
And Kane takes Fuck way out
with one arm. A one-arm choke slam from the seven-foot monster.
And Kane back down, but Fuck grabs him right by the throat. What's he going to do with him?
Oh, no. The same thing that Kane did to The Undertaker at Bad Blood.
Kane, oh! Driving Flash Fuck headfirst into the canvas. Kane wanting The Undertaker. And as JR said, until he gets him, he's going to make The Undertaker's life a living hell.
A picture is worth a thousand words.
You can say that again.
Undertaker, everything you've ever dreamed of, we're going to take away. Everything that you want to accomplish, we're going to take away. Human eye has not seen, nor human ear heard, what Kane has in store for his brother, The Undertaker. We're going to stroll through the WWF, just like I said, destroying everybody in Kane's path until he meets his brother face to face. And Undertaker, you will never rest in peace. Ashes to ashes!
Kane!
I'm gonna look into the creepy, eerie mask.
New love against the British Bulldog. We saw him earlier on out here with the Hart Foundation.
Old
man will be headed back to Long Island this Friday night. Nassau Coliseum, he'll be going home. Just like old JR tomorrow night in Tulsa.
Is your mom going to be there tomorrow night, JR?
Well, I hope she's able to come, King.
You make me wish your parents had never met.
Wait a minute. It's when the Bulldog have a blackout.
Oh, no.
That ain't Bulldog music. Gallfire and brimstone. It's Kane.
It's that monster Kane, along with Paul Bearer. This huge monster, this brother of The Undertaker.
This match is scheduled to be Dude Love and the British Bulldog, and obviously Kane, along with Paul Bearer, have other plans.
And perhaps the comments of The Undertaker inciting Kane
Kane's gonna come out here whenever he wants. You don't believe that? Ask Slash Funk. If I was Dude, I'd exit stage left right now.
Dude Love ain't gonna run, but maybe he should.
You're not lying.
The power of Kane. Ah! The flames of hell igniting here tonight. And Dude hammering away on that mask that Kane wears. And Dude now from the other side, and Dude over the other top.
And landing.
Just like the Undertaker, Kane landed on his feet.
And we are in darkness, you can hardly see. And
Dude's looking for a weapon, I think.
He's trying to hide, he's running under the ring. I don't blame you, Dude.
Dude just nailed. Did you see that? Dude just leveled. Well, he didn't level him. He's still on his feet. Kane took that chair. And now Kane comes down.
On the steel. A choke slam on the steel. Dude Love's head just smacked that steel.
Dude's dead.
And Kane wreaking hot carnage here. Look at this. Kane coming out. Dude Love was to have scheduled. It was supposed to be Dude Love against the Bulldog. And
oh no,
no, no, no, no, no! Oh! And the head of Dude bouncing off the steel. And look at what, look what Kane has done.
Everybody stop Kane.
That's so Commissioner Slaughter has made the match now.
Absolutely. November the 9th, Montreal. Oh, and
wait a minute.
We're gonna be joined momentarily by the Undertaker's brother. I'm not looking forward to this.
Why is it JR always gets these easy assignments? Unbelievable! Oh! Unbelievable impact that Kane walking through hellfire itself on his way to the ring. And that smirk on Paul Bearer's face. Paul Bearer going online, America Online, this Thursday, 9 o'clock Eastern. I'm sure he'll be having a great deal to say about Kane. Kane has promised to make The Undertaker's life a living hell until The Undertaker locks up with Kane. Something The Undertaker has stated he will never, ever do, fight his brother. Look at it.
Oh, and again! Fire spewing from the ring!
This will take place a little bit later here tonight, so
Ahmed just couldn't wait! He came straight out here, and we're still looking for Steve Austin.
Until hell freezes over. We know that Kane's on his way to the Survivor Series to meet Mankind. That pay-per-view spectacular will be absolutely awesome on Sunday. But what's going on here right now?
We never knew he was going to be here. And it certainly wasn't a challenge between Ahmed and Kane.
Ahmed Johnson not backing down from this monster that has dominated each and everybody that he has come in front of.
Ahmed Johnson, I think, took a half step back, and that's the farthest he's gone back since he's been in the WWF.
Ahmed Johnson with right hands. Ahmed Johnson knows he's got to defend himself here. This is not a matchup. And the reverse, a choke slam.
Good God.
Ahmed drill with a choke slam, and that's 300. And 10 pounds of Ahmed Johnson.
And Kane standing over Ahmed Johnson. Oh, jeez!
man is up. It's going to be a tombstone. This is the Undertaker's move, tombstone pile driver.
Look at Paul Bearer. Paul Bearer saying to Kane, do it again, do it again.
Well, you better do it again if you don't want Ahmed Johnson to get back up. Oh, come on.
Kane, he's going to do it again.
Now two tombstone pile drivers.
Two could put him out.
Oh, good grief. And wait a minute. Here comes Mankind. Mankind.
He's got the claw.
Mankind, lamentable claw from Paul Bearer.
And he's got him. He bent that huge turnbuckle. Something hooked both. Kane's down. Kane maybe.
Oh, Kane's up. My God, he's set up just like the Undertaker. Just like his brother.
Mankind, he's got a chair. Ahmed can hardly stand.
What in the hell will it take to keep this man down?
Can any human being stop Kane? What's it gonna take?
Kane's a monster.
Something from somebody to go ahead and leave instead of flaunting it in their face.
Oh, they
look
pace,
at this.
Pace is quickening here. And, Sonny with a nice little leapfrog there. Put on the...
What?
Or the power failure?
No. No, I can't believe this.
Now this is hideous. What do you intend to do?
Oh, I've always liked you.
What do you intend to do out here? Oh, God.
Hey, look.
My God, we need some help out here. Wait, the headbangers. An act of bravery or stupidity by the former WWF Tag Champions.
No.
And they can't, both of them can't even take this monster off his feet.
JR, we ought to follow the Minis. They're out of here. He's taking the headbangers apart, two against one, piece by piece.
This 7-foot monster, the younger brother of The Undertaker, is absolutely devastating. Here comes a tombstone pile driver.
And you said it right. He's the younger brother, not the little brother. He's bigger. He may be stronger.
Oh, look. Kane is just manhandled again, and another tombstone. My God, look at the carnage.
One man, two man. It doesn't make any difference. Kane cannot be stopped. And The Undertaker just last week said he would never fight his own flesh and blood. But Paul Bearer has sworn the carnage will continue.
Brasher and Moss have been devastated by this monster. Look at the size of this man, the ferocity.
He is inhuman. He made me invulnerable.
What a being. What an animal. The crush wins by a result of a forfeit. And we have more power problems, apparently. Look out. It's Austin back in the... Oh, oh my God. apparently for Crush.
A nightmare for Crush. He got a win by forfeit, and now his way to the exit is cut off by this monster, Kane. I'd go out the back way if I were you, Crush.
Last week it was the Headbangers. There's been a long line of victims left in Kane's wake. But Crush, at 6 feet eight, 300 pounds, is going to fight, and he's got to fight for his life here. But everything Crush is attempting seemingly doesn't affect this monster. Oh, it may be time for a ride with a hell of a landing. Can you imagine the impact and the feeling when you're driven spine first by a 7 foot, 300 plus pound man?
He's not a man, Kane's a beast.
Tombstone!
Oh my God!
Tombstone! Tombstone! Well, Crush is hurt. Crush is hurt. And here comes the DOA. Crush is hurt. He may have. He's got to have a bad neck injury right there. And the DOA are in the ring. Uh oh.
We got all kinds of.
Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
Hey. Gerald Briscoe!
Oh! Briscoe inadvertently bumped into Kane. My God, we need an ambulance. This is carnage. The DOA getting Crush out of here through hellfire and brimstone. My God. Kane is going to make Undertaker's life and everyone else in the WWF a living hell until the Undertaker agrees to fight his brother.
And I've heard it, like I said, till I've had enough to hear about how dangerous.
Oh, God. Oh,
where are you, JR?
This is supposed to be Scott Taylor and Brian Christopher.
Wait a minute, is this Brian? This is not Brian's entrance music.
It sure is. Oh,
wow.
My!
Where's Brian?
Here comes Kane! Along with Paul Bearer Kane, the Undertaker's little brother at 7 feet tall, took apart Crush last week. And my God, Scott Taylor should run for his life.
Think he did something to Brian? This guy's a human wrecking machine.
Paul Bearer has made it clear. Look at Scott Taylor. Scott Taylor looked like he's frozen.
He's
in
like
fear.
He's a deer in the headlights. Get out of the ring, you little idiot. Run.
And look at the. Oh, you better run, Taylor.
No.
Scott Taylor, well, he's gamely trying to defend himself, and those drop kicks have absolutely no effect on this big monster. What is going to happen to all of us before the Undertaker accepts his brother's challenge?
I don't know, but I know something bad's gonna happen to Scott Taylor if he don't turn tail and run. Get out of there, too late.
Claw Taylor with a drop kick off the top to no avail, and there is the choke slam.
Look at this.
Oh, tremendous power and velocity. Taylor's spine just impacting the canvas. Oh, but Kane's not through.
Kane just held Scott Taylor up for that choke slam for 5 or 10 seconds, and now,
a tombstone pile driver. Scott Taylor has been decimated, and how in the world is he going to be able to compete against Brian Christopher for this light heavyweight semifinal matchup?
Well, I can just tell you this. This is simply another message that's being sent to the Undertaker.
Undertaker! I hope you're happy! All this carnage at the hands of your brother Kane is your fault! And it's going to continue until you do! you have to do. Right now, Undertaker, your life is already a living hell.
No.
What's going on? Power failure.
Tell me it's a power failure, please.
Oh, no. You gotta be kidding me.
Paul Bear broken his shoulder. We got six people down.
Oh, no. The Godwins have hightailed it out of the ring. Michael, I've seen this on TV before. This is the first time I've seen it live. There's nothing like Kane. What a presence. And Hawk appears to be in the ring by himself.
As JR mentioned, Animal receiving medical attention outside the ring. Incapacitated. The Godwins have hightailed it out. Road Dogg and Billy Gunn nowhere to be found. And Hawk is all alone.
The Undertaker's brother stepping over the top rope.
Oh, no.
And Kane with a pile driver on Hawk. And Hawk.
Oh, no.
Showing that neck jumping right up, but I don't think he's gonna get up from this. A choke slam. Hawk trying with everything he's got to get back up.
Paul Bearer calling for the tombstone again. Oh no, not a second time.
Oh. Kane, the 7-footer, the one-eyed monster, just drilled Hawk with that tombstone pile driver.
Kane get in the face of his brother last night at Degeneration X in your house. And here on Raw, he perhaps has destroyed Hawk.
Hawk is barely moving. In the center of the ring, Animal is hurt outside the ring.
And the tag team champions are cowering over by our Spanish colleagues.
Is anyone in the World Wrestling Federation safe?
Somebody is gonna rest in peace.
Uh-oh. Oh no.
You can almost feel it coming. You can almost sense the presence of the Undertaker's brother, Kane.
What's the Undertaker gonna do? Is this the night where he finally stands up to his younger brother?
It looks as if the Undertaker will be given that opportunity. Because the Undertaker's little brother, Kane, and that heinous Paul Bearer are not coming to the ring for a family reunion. This may just be the moment that we've all been waiting for. This could get very, very ugly in a hurry.
These two men like mirror images of the other.
All the agony of all the WWF superstars that they're going through right now is all your fault. The list is growing day by day. I'm gonna give you one more chance, dead man. One more chance. One more chance to step up to the plate. One more chance to be a man for all your leeches of the night. You must face your brother. Yes, you must face him.
Oh! Oh.
The two brothers looking,
it's like looking into his own soul.
Taker's walking away. This man take.
It may not be over tonight, Jim.
Folks, this is a big night.
Last week we saw Kane slap The Undertaker. Undertaker did not retaliate.
I invite the entire world to feast your eyes upon your phenom. Look at him. You're nothing but a shell of a man that you once were.
I don't believe that. I'll never believe that.
I gave you one last chance last week, dead man, to step up and face your brother. And what did you do? You took tail and ran.
I don't think he ran. He refused to fight his brother, as he said all along he would not do.
I have to say that I am totally ashamed to say that I ever had anything to do with you.
I'm sure the feeling is mutual.
I can't believe that I once stood by your side so proud and called myself your friend.
Look at the look.
You're nothing anymore. Nothing at all. And what's so sad, your poor parents are celebrating this holiday season with the maggots and the worms.
Good God. Oh, come on.
Oh, look out. Look out. He went for Paul Bearer.
Kane's attacking his brother. Wait a minute.
He's going to fight back. The Undertaker.
The Undertaker's had enough.
No. He had a chance, J.R.
Undertaker refusing to fight. Refusing. Oh, no. Like Kane is right here before our very eyes. The Undertaker is hurt.
Desperately trying to grab the rope to get to his feet.
I told you he's nothing.
Well, Paul Bearer loves this.
Is your proof.
Paul Bearer loves this.
The broken form of The Undertaker slumped in the corner.
1998 will be the year of Kane.
How much more will The Undertaker take? Or maybe more specifically, how much more can he take?
Oh my gosh! Welcome to hell! The Undertaker, lying in the corner. He had a chance. He had a chance to defend himself.
Season's beatings, dead man.
The Undertaker has just experienced quite the dose of hell.
Obviously, Kane, week after week you come out here and you lay him in the middle of the ring. Well, you haven't been burnt. You think The Undertaker burnt you, your brother. Wait till your ass gets burnt by the DOA and the rest of the crew. So step on down the ramp, because we're going to put your damn fire out.
What? You ask and you shall receive. So saith Kane. Seven-foot younger brother of The Undertaker. It's finally going to happen tonight. Kane is going to get what he deserves. The destruction of Kane is imminent.
Paul Bearer may have the baddest thing walking, but I don't think there's any human
to seven superstars from the WWF at one time, but he's obviously going to try.
All these men, in one way or another, have had Kane devastate their professional career.
Thorn that's been stabbed in his side since Kane appeared.
Whoa! Fight you.